MOU signed with the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia a few years ago with the Ministry of Health, and I would say the outcome was poor. The Saudi side didn't stick to for reasons that are known, because when you find health professionals like what they call a free ride, then you wouldn't like to commit yourself to a bilateral agreement. And as I will be telling shortly, migration within the context of the Middle East is a challenging issue. And there is a dynamic, a special dynamics which contrasts to global dynamics. Also, we have had an MOU with the United Kingdom Academy of Medical Royal Colleges, and still the outcome is to be seen. We have a recent memorandum of understanding with Libya, which is coming up as a strong destination country in the post-war era and in the new system in Libya. And I would say this is promising, because it is an agreement between the two governments. And recently, we have had 500 medical doctors recruited to Libya through governmental arrangements with no interference from recruitment agencies. And the process went smooth, and it kept, I think, like mutual benefit for the two countries, and it protected health professionals and medical doctors from exploitation by the recruitment agencies, which was the practice that is seen in the recent years. Sudan is also now contributing to regional efforts, like we have the Arab League of Ministers of Health. There is an upcoming conference on migration within the Middle East that we are participating in Cairo. And there are some efforts in WHO, EMRO, where Human Resource for Health Strategy is prepared, and we were part of that, and as well the Arab Medical Union. In another dimension, as a response in migration management, we have this diaspora mobilization, either permanent or temporary in terms of government initiatives and in term of private sector role. And we are seeing now rising numbers of Sudanese specialists being attracted back to the country, in particular by the private sectors. But these issues are not without challenges. And I think we will be discussing tomorrow a little bit around these issues. We have the contribution of diaspora in different facets, and there is an increasing collaboration with local institutions from agencies such as the SMA in UK and Ireland. But we also need to see where are we now and how to proceed in a structured way. And I think this is one of the mandates of this conference, and in particular, the discussion that we are looking forward tomorrow. These are some of the activities for the diaspora. Now coming to the challenges, we have rising trends of migration among doctors, leading to loss of capacity and institutional memory in several educational institutions and in healthcare institutions, as you have seen from the figures and the trends. We have potential migration increase among other cadres. Whereas Sudan is facing nursing shortages and shortages in allied health professions, we are seeing now signs of migration among these cadres to countries like Saudi Arabia and Libya. And this comes with the introduction of higher education in this, among these cadres. And we have challenge of coordination and sustainability of diaspora efforts, your efforts to contribute to your country back. We are, as I earlier spoke, managing migration in a complex regional context. The Middle East context is probably very complex in terms of migration, like reluctance of destination countries to enter into bilateral agreements, like active recruitment bouts, which we are now seeing more and more of it, with distortion of planning in the country and exploitation, actually, of medical doctors and other health professions. Lack of information exchange between sending and receiving countries is another challenge. And signs for rising need. Of course, this is for a country like Sudan, with a potential in production of medical doctors and with good reputation, we see the rising need in destination countries as a challenge, like the Gulf. The other day we attended with His Excellency the Federal Minister of Health a meeting in Jordan, and the Minister of Health in Saudi Arabia was telling that within the next 5 years, the number of health facilities are going to double in Saudi Arabia. And in a country like Sudan, this is a bell. This is ringing a bell for us, because we know very well that our doctors are going to staff part of those facilities. And I told you also about Libya. Now the Libyan government is expressed in writing to His Excellency, the Federal Minister of Health, the interest of the Libyan government in particular to recruit Sudanese medical doctors. And we received the first delegate from Libya last month, and they took 500 medical doctors, and the rest will follow. As Nuan, and I think Rory is aware of this, the West also, United Kingdom, Republic of Ireland, USA, and other countries, there is a rising need, and there is a huge gap in nursing and in medicine. Finally, the prospects dialogue started in Sudan to formulate a policy direction. We have a dialogue around retention efforts in the country for the health workforce. And we have an evidence-informed policy movement, as I was talking about the database and these things. And we have could be called a positive role of private sector. And we have immigration. Sudan is mainly a sending country, but also we receive health workers from other countries like Egypt, India, Philippines, and other countries. And there is some people attracted by the private sector. We have diaspora mobilization and return migration. We have this vivid diaspora in the United Kingdom, in Ireland, elsewhere, and the how-to question is there to really try to discuss with you how this contribution could be structured in a better way. And during this conference, we will be having a questionnaire which will be distributed for all of you, and I hope that we get a response to this, because it will be one of the milestones in trying to really structure this process and see what is our role in the government, in the Minister of Health in Sudan, and what is the role of diaspora, and how can we make it effective and efficient. There are emerging regional platforms and initiatives I talked about, and there are model and encouraging agreements like that, which we did with Libya. Thank you very much.